In the case of the ABO gene, the DNA sequence will be transcribed into an RNA copy or intermediate that will leave the nucleus and go to the cytoplasm where it will be translated by ribosomes into protein. Now we're about to dive deep into these processes called transcription and translation. But first, we should learn a bit more about this RNA copy that's so critical to the transfer of genetic information.
So if we follow the central dogma in our example of blood type, our ABO gene made of DNA is going to be turned into an ABO RNA copy that can be trafficked to the cytoplasm, and here it will be turned into the ABO protein by ribosomes. Now these two arrows here that connect DNA to RNA and RNA to protein are what we're about to dive deep into. These processes are called transcription and translation. And by the end of this lesson, you'll see exactly how a DNA code is turned into protein. But for us to dive deep into these processes, we really need to understand a bit more about this critical intermediate copy, RNA. You'll remember from lesson 2 that DNA is made of deoxynucleotides, and that's what I'm showing you here. This is the chemical structure we looked at when we studied deoxynucleotides. And in this case, there's an adenine, or an A, as the nitrogenous base that's attached. Now, RNA is, chemically speaking, incredibly similar to DNA. In fact, you should only be able to notice one difference about the chemical structure of RNA compared to DNA. RNA is made of nucleotides instead of deoxynucleotides. And what I want you to try to do, select the region that distinguishes DNA from RNA. Focus down here on the RNA nucleotide, and there are 4 regions to choose from. I want you to pick the one that you think distinguishes it from the DNA deoxynucleotide.